My name is Michael Raymond, and this is my story.
About 15 years, I never could get sober. I just couldn't do it. So I dug down deep inside myself. I ran from myself from years. All the pain and frustration I went through, I went to about 15 rehabs, jails, institutions, death. Jailed 17 times, you name it. I did it. My addiction stole, kicked in doors. Everything I could do to get high destroyed my family, myself, everybody around. I used all my government-funded money in order to get to rehab. So Pine Street was my last chance to get in there. It was my last rehab. I can't go back to another one. It was my last chance for recovery resource to pay for it. So it was my last chance, and I went there and did really good in the program. I left there and made it about 5 months. And I went to UGM and doing pretty good there, and started taking my antidepressants, which worked wonders. And one day I just started smoking pot again and drinking. It came out of nowhere, because at that time I still wasn't ready. Deep down inside, I actually had no hope that God was real. I didn't actually believe in Him. I mean, I had a little theory that He was there, because I had so many things in my life happen. I should have been dead many a times, but I didn't die, so it had to have been Him. I've done enough apologizing and all that, but the only person I can really make amends to is God. So I've been running from Him so many years and all that, and I never believed in Him. I just didn't think He was real. I just figured that everything that happened to me was coincidence. Until I came behind Fellowship Church, and I don't know what it was, something hit me. And the first time in my life, I got this feeling, I'm like, well, what am I doing? I'm 28 years old, and I'm sleeping behind a church. I've been doing drugs first time I got drunk was 5 years old. And I say about since I was 16, I've been getting high every day and whatnot, and I just finally asked myself, Michael, do you think this is working anymore? You've been doing this for how many years, and look where you're at, and you keep on wanting to run from yourself, and you can't face nothing? You need to do something. And I remember that night, I got on my hands and knees, and I prayed. And the next day, I met Pastor Chris and everything like that, and I don't know what it was, you started talking. I just started getting involved in the church and volunteering. At the time, I had my doubts, because I just figured I'd work at the church for a little while, and there still sleep outside, and nothing good would happen. But then I started doing what was funny was all them people in the place couldn't believe that I kept doing the next right thing. They're like, Michael, who are you? How you've changed so quick? And the answer is easy. I have so much determination inside of me and so much pain and depression that before I came, I honestly gave up. I had 2 suicide attempts. I tried to kill myself twice. That's how bad it got. I, at the loss of my grandma, that was one thing that made me do it, because all the things that I put her through, I promised her I'd clean up, but I never did, and all that. And something that night just clicked, and I said, I cannot do this no more. My depression got to the point that I couldn't get out of bed. I just sit there in bed. I have no desire to do anything. I didn't want to shower. I didn't want to do anything. I had no hope. I was basically a dead man walking with nothing. Nothing in the head, no feelings, no nothing. Like just being there, dead to everything. Saying, oh, Michael, I've had a good life. It's over with. There's no way you can get back what you had before. There's no way you get these feelings back. And so far, they're actually starting to come back now. It's crazy, because the thing about getting sober is when you first get sober, being happy is the most scariest thing you'll ever do in the world when you're a drug addict. And a lot of people say, how is that possible? Well, because you ran for so long. And with doing drugs, the reason why people use drugs is we as drug addicts sit there and cause pain on ourselves, because we want to feel something in order to get high to cover that up. That's the reason why we use. But I thank the church for being there for me. I thank you, Michael. He rocks. Anyway, I like my sponsor, Don, and all them people who have helped me. And it's God. You know, I have my days sometimes when I still go off into my own over the world sometimes, do things my way. But then I stop and realize that if you don't do it God's way, my way is not going to work. And some people don't understand that, because they say, well, once you get cleaned up, you're still doing it your way. When I say don't do it your way, that means don't do what you used to do. Don't live the way you used to live. Because my way, if I had my way, I'd be high 24/7, trying to have a job, trying to do this, and I'd never succeed at it. Because every time I get high and drunk, all the negativity, all the pain in my life comes to the surface, and I can't handle it. And then I'm back really hard to dig down deep inside yourself, because that's the hardest thing you'll ever do. But with addiction, that's the only way you can beat it, because the reason why we use is to feel good about everything. And like with me was, the only way I could beat it was every time what you have to do with addiction, every problem you have to write it down, and you have to dig down deep inside yourself. And once you figure out who you are and what it is you're running from, slowly by slowly you build up your strength, and then once you do the right thing, you stop and look back at why you got high, and you call yourself, man, that's pretty stupid. Why did I do that? And the more you do that, the more you don't want to use. And once you start getting things in your life like a job and happiness and cars and all that kind of stuff like that, you don't have a reason to go back. My main goal was if I could stay sober and whatnot, which I am, is be a counselor, to help people to prevent the life that I... To be honest with you, I'm blown away in a lot of ways. I got a job now, I'm healthy, I'm clean, and I don't have no desire to use.